We'll discuss about the automation model. So we have started the introduction related to the formal languages, and we learned what is formal language and what is automata theory and all. Now you are moving into the actual concepts. In the previous class, we discussed about the various kinds of languages. You are having several four categories of languages over there. Out of the four categories, means type 0, type 1, type 2, type 3 languages, out of the four categories of the languages, so we are going to be learning about the first category, means when coming to the complexity of the particular automation, the highest complexity is Turing machine, and then linear bounded automata. You're having push down automata, and at the final we are having the finite automata, means the order mean it has to start from the finite automata, and we need to learn about the Turing machines. So when coming to the automation, the general definition of an automation is an abstract model of a digital computer. The abstract model of a digital computer, you can call it as a automation. So when coming to the digital computer, you can have the simple representation of a digital computer. You'll have an input file and control unit, and then we are having the storage, mainly these three things. So from that we are going to be getting the output. So input file, control unit, and the storage. So when coming to the input file, so you can see the input file. Input file, you are having a string over the alphabets, means you are taking sigma equals to, I am taking sigma equals to A comma B, and the string it is generating is A B B, something like this. So whenever we are going to be representing the input alphabet like this, so the input file, so this is the input file. The input file, so it will stores, means it will holds the values, and we are reading from the left to the right. So whenever you are reading, you are representing A B B, so you are going to be moving, reading the values from left to the right. And whenever whatever the input symbol we are represented here, that will be identified by using the input file. So whatever the input strings, alphabets they are represented, that all the input representations are stored in the particular file. So that we are going to be storing into the input file. When coming to the storage, already we know that mainly storage, we can call it as a memory. So the memory, we are not going to be storing directly the memory. The memory is going to be partitioning into the cells. That's what we are having the various concepts in the operating system. We are learning about how to split the storage into the operating memory, and what kind of replacement algorithms are there. That all we learn in the operating system. So in coming to the storage, means a location where I can store the data, or where I can store the particular elements. So you cannot say that the particular storage I am having only these many number of cells. So you are having so many number of cells, you cannot count it. So in the cells, whatever the memory cells, so these are all the partitions we are identified here. So here, so from these cells we are going to be storing the particular values. So each cell holds a symbol from an alphabet, means we are going to be storing each and every cell, each and every alphabet in the cell. So whatever the data or whatever the particular cell you are representing, that you can able to read, and you can able to perform the write operation, means I can able to read for one string, and after the completion I can able to replace that string, that you can call it as an write, that is indicated as a W. So that's we are going to be using for the, so identifying the data to perform some sort of operations that can be identified in the storage. When coming to the next, you are using the control unit. So control unit, the main operations can be performed by using the control unit. So everything, all the execution can be done by the control unit. When coming to the control unit in finite automata, how to represent this control unit? So normally control means whether I can able to move or I have to stop. Normally control means I am moving on the way. So this is a traffic signal. So from this traffic signal, I have to move onto the road or I have to stop. Means there is a control at the particular location to stop or to proceed. When coming to here also, I am having a control unit. So the finite automata has to perform some sort of operation. To perform these operations, this control unit is going to be performing some sort of conditions. So going to be doing this one, whatever the operations you are indicating here, that all the operations we are representing in the form of a states. So you are having several states, and with the indication of states from one state to the another state, the control can be indicated. The control unit will manages the number of this. Your initially I have started from Q naught, and from the Q naught where I have to move. So it has to identify the input symbol, whether it is 0 or whether it is 1. So based upon the input string, it has to decide whether I have to move from Q naught to Q1 or else Q naught to Q2. So I need to decide whether I have to move from Q naught to Q1 or else I have to go from Q naught to Q2. The control unit will take care about the movement of the particular states based upon the input signals. So you are having Q0, Q1, Q2. These are all the states. These are all the states, and 0, 1 are the alphabets. 0, 1 are the alphabets. So you can see the real-time comparison, how we can able to compare our finite automata. The first example, vending machine. So the vending machine, if you want to get any items, I want to insert a coin, and based upon the value, I need to get the items. So the vending machines, whenever I inserted a coin, the vending machine has to accept either maybe a single coin or maybe a two coins, like this. So you can take the weight checking machine. In the bus stands and railway stations, you'll have the weight checking machines also there. So there I need to insert a coin, whether I want to take 1 rupee coin or 2 rupees coin, I need to insert. Whenever I inserted the particular coin, the machine has to accept it and it has to permit me to do the particular operation. So in the same way, here it has to accept, the vending machine has to accept the sequence of coins, because I want a particular item on the machine. So I want to insert up to the price is reaching and I will get the particular item. That's what, there's an example. And second, looms. So means you all know that the hand looms. So I want a particular design. The design means whatever the design I want to print onto the loom, I will prepare everything, and whatever the pattern I want to print, that I will give it as an input. The pattern, whatever means in our language, you may treat it as a the particular design. It may be a design. So whatever the design you want to give, so the design, whatever the design we are giving, it has to take the input representation, means it needs to read the value from the particular item, and the same thing it has to replicate, means whatever the design I want to print, that has to print on my sari or else some dress or else on some other items. So what are the handlooms you are using? That's the second one. When coming to the next example, so you can take the tape recorders and some microphones. So the tape recorder, you all know that whenever you are inserting a tape recorder, it has to read the particular input value, and based upon the input values, it has to convert the data, means it has to convert the input values into the form of a sound. It has to convert into the form of a sound, means you are going to be reading the data. So here also you are reading the data, here also you are accepting the data. When coming to the last one, so majority of the languages, means every program, it has to read a specific input based upon the sequence of characters, and it has to take the appropriate action. Appropriate action means I am giving some input, that input is print, that input is print. So it will take an action related to the instruction passed by the input command. So it will decide that, so I want to print some data. On the same, this is the real-time comparison with the finite automata, how a machine reads the data and it will perform. There are various categories, you are using the various categories. I am accepting the data, the first example, I am accepting and I am performing, and in some example I am accepting and performing, in other examples I am giving some sort of outputs. So the same, whenever you are going to be learning about the types of the automations, you are having two categories of the automata over there. There are two types of automata. So the first category, the first type of automata are acceptors, and the second transducers. So acceptor, you can see the acceptor, it will take the input and it will decide whether it is accepted or whether it is not accepted. So that's why they will call it as an acceptors. So acceptors, it will give you the result, it will say, so it may be a true or it may be a false. So if it is true, it will say that yes, the particular input value is accepted. Otherwise, if it is not accepted, it will say that the particular input value is not accepted. So that's the first one. When coming to the second one, transducers, it will produce the output in the form of a string. It will produce the output in the form of a string, means you are going to be giving some input and I am performing some kind of an operation and it is going to be producing an output. So I am giving input and it performing the operation, and after the completion of the operation, it is producing the output. That's what you can call it as a transducers. So examples of the acceptors are DFA, deterministic finite automata, and NFA is a non-deterministic finite automata. What is NFA and what is DFA, we are going to be learning now. And coming to the examples of transducers, we are having two kinds of machines, one is Miller machine and second one is Moore machine. So these are the different, based upon our representation, we are going to be designing an automation. So you can see the finite state machine. So we are going to be accepting, you are taking as a computational model, we are going to be using for hardware or software representation, and we are going to be checking some sequential logical operation, and based upon that we are going to be deciding. It's a simple mathematical representation, or else a computational model of the thing, whatever the operations you want to perform, that you are going to be using by using the finite state machine. So we will see some of the applications of the finite automata, where finite state automata is using. The first one, the compilers break the input string into logical units. So you can see, whenever you're having so many compilers over there, you are having C compiler, you are having C++ compiler, you are having Java. Each and every programming languages, we are having a set of compilers. So by using this compiler, so you are having a C compiler. Whenever you have written a program in C language, it is not just a single line or a single word. We are going to be writing a sequence of instructions. We are going to be writing a sequence of instructions, mean line 1, line 2, line 3, and so on and so on. So we are going to be using the sequence of the instructions. So the sequence of instructions, now compiler has to decide whether you entered a valid input string or not. The compiler has to decide whether it is a valid input string or not. So to give whether it is valid or it is invalid. So if it is valid, then you need, it has to say that it is valid representation. So otherwise it has to show the error. It has to show the error because the compiler cannot recognize the particular input. So this is what we are going to be using, that the logical units means we are going to be splitting the entire whatever the instructions they are represented here, that all splitted into the different kinds of inputs, different kinds of logical units. So in the same, we are going to be using the programming languages. We are identifying a circuit. So finite automata, we are designing some circuit same like as a computer digital circuit, and we are going to be estimating the performance. And you are having the various kinds of text editors. So we are going to be using the various kinds of the text editors. So you can see Notepad, WordPad, MS Word. There are so many text editors are there. Even the Turbo C, Turbo C++, Java text editors. There are so many text editors are there. So whenever you are going to be entering an input value into the text editors, it's going to be deciding that the input entered by you is accepted or not. Means it will indicate you, at least it will give you some kind of information related to the text entered by you. So best example, you can see MS Word. So MS Word, if suppose I entered some term as a spelling mistake. So edanoka term ni, suppose I want to enter program PRAGRAM. If suppose I have written like this instead of PROGRAM, I have written it as a PROGRAM. So program. So automatically it will indicate by underlining the red symbol. Means it is showing you that there is some error. The string is having some error in terms of you are having different various symbols over there. You are having a red underline and you are having green underline. So red underline indicates that you are having a spelling mistake. So red will indicate the spelling mistake. Green will indicate the grammar mistake. So user is an user friendly representation. User can simply identify where they are having a problem and they will try to resolve the issues. So that's what where we are going to be using this finite automata. So there are two main important categories of finite automata over there. First automata is deterministic finite automata and second is non-deterministic finite automata. When coming to the deterministic finite automata, these two are very very important. The first deterministic finite automata, the transition system is deterministic if every transition represents only one result. So every transition represents only one result. The automation goes, means it goes to the only one state. That you will see the example now. And you can see the definition of non-deterministic. the transition system, when you will call it as a non-deterministic, means every transition represents any number of results. Every transition represents any number of results. In the previous one, DFA, every transition represents only one result. But in the non-deterministic, every transition represents any number of results. Any number of results. So, transition. So, we'll see an example here. You see the example. This is an example for the deterministic. So, deterministic finite automata. So, here Q0, Q1, Q2. I'm having three states. So, the Q0, with the Q0, I'm having two possibilities when Q0 is on 0 and Q0 is on 1. And as well as for the Q1, you are having the two possibilities when Q1 is 0 and Q1 is 1. And for Q2, if you are having any possibilities, 0 and then 1. So here, as per the definition, Q0 on 0, Q0 on 0 implies to only one state, means it has to go only one state. Means in the given example, you consider Q0, 0, it is moving to Q1 and you are not having any other option. And Q0 on 1, you are moving to Q2. There's another option. You can see the Q1. Q1 on 0, it is going to Q0. Q1 on 1, it is going to self loop. It's on 1. You don't have any transitions. That whatever the operations you are doing there, means the Q0, 0 implies Q1. This is called it as a transition. Q0, Q1, Q2, these three will call it as a state. The operations you are moving from one state to the another state based upon a specific input, you can call it as a transition. This is an example for the DFA. You come to the NFA, non-deterministic finite automata. Here you can see the difference. I am having sigma equals to A comma B comma C. So I have taken three input alphabets. So as per the definition, so Q0 having the possibility, Q0 on A, Q0 on B, Q0 on C. And coming to same, we are having the various possibility. It depends upon the input alphabets. So it's not mandatory that you should have all Q0 on A, Q0 on B, Q0 on C, Q1 on A, Q1 on B, Q1 on C. There is no specific restriction like that. So you can take, so based upon our requirement, it's going to be storing the, moving the transition from one state to the another state. You can take Q0 on A, you take Q0 on A. So it's moving to the states. One is Q0 on A is going to again Q0, and Q0 on A it's going to Q1 again. So Q0 on A, the transitions Q0 comma Q1 means it's more than one. So it may be any number. It may be any number. It means it more than one. So here Q0 on A moving again to the Q0 means self transition, and Q0 on 1 it is moving to Q0 on A, it's moving again to Q1, means the transition is going to be generating, means it's giving more than one operations, more than one states, Q0 and Q1. So that's what non-deterministic finite automata. So in the next class, we'll discuss about what's the formal language and what is informal language. So what is the formal language and what is informal language? What is the language representations of the regular language, means a regular language and non-regular language. So how to recognize a particular language is a regular language, and how to recognize a particular language is non-regular language. And then we need to move for the finite automata representations, and how, what is it, how to represent NFA, how to represent DFA, how to draw the transition diagrams and all. So if you are having any queries, you please drop a comment section. So I'll answer in the comment section. Thank you.